Now it's time to head out on the road. It is the WATD South Shore Morning Tour. We're going to head to a town that used to be known as Little Comfort. Now it's known as the town of Whitman. Rob and Lisa, take it away.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour on 95.9 WATD. Now, live on the green in front of Whitman Town Hall, here's Rob Hakala and Lisa Azizian.
All right, yeah, good morning. And welcome, thank you early folks for coming on by. Yeah, we're right out here on the green. Good morning. We are coming to you from just outside Whitman Town Hall on a beautiful Friday morning. We do this on the final Friday of every month. We bring the program out on the road, the South Shore Morning Tour. And we're going to be with you right up till 10 o'clock today, learning a lot about the town of Whitman, learning about its history. We're going to be chatting with the police and fire chief, also the school superintendent, with the library director. It's going to be a great day, Lisa. A lot of folks coming by today to talk about this wonderful community of Whitman.
I love being set up here in Whitman. First of all, it's beautiful right here in front of the town hall. Absolutely beautiful. And it's a very intimate setting. There's some beautiful lush trees out here. And we have to thank the folks at the town hall. They've been promoting our arrival here right on their front sign. It says, "Welcome, WATD." So maybe you've heard that we've been coming to Whitman and we can't wait to see you. So stop on by. We've got free coffee this morning. I know as you're rubbing your eyes and you're waking up and you're maybe like me hitting snooze a few times on that alarm, come on down and get a free cup of coffee this morning. It's the best way to start the day.
Absolutely. You get a free cup of coffee and also those delicious cinnamon sticks as well from Honeydew Donuts. And we want to bring in Kara Bowen, who is with us today from Honeydew Donuts. She's here to talk about what's going to be given away today. And we'll also get into a little preview as well, Kara, about some of the upcoming items at the Honeydew locations. But right now we're on the town green right now in front of Whitman Town Hall, and I know you've been with us right from the very beginning. We did May in Hanover in early May, and then we went to Weymouth and then to Marshfield, and this is our final stop on the South Shore Morning Tour for 2015 on this 28th day of August. Kara, good morning.
Good morning, Rob. Good morning, Lisa. So excited to be here on the final stop.
I know it's a little bittersweet, isn't it?
It is. It really, really is. You know, it seems like we just started, and here we are at the last one.
I know.
But, oh, what a beautiful Friday, though, for sure. So I'm very excited to be here.
All right. Now, what are some of the items we got? We got those famous cinnamon sticks that we know and love.
Oh, yes. I got plenty of those, and we have hot coffee. So, as Lisa said, as you're waking up and rubbing your eyes and getting a start on this day, come on down and see us.
All right. Well, it's a great to get to. It's easy to get to. We're right in front of the town hall in Whitman, so we'd love to have you come on down and see us today, and we're going to be with you till 10 o'clock. Kara, let's talk about and thank some of your great stories, because I know, you know, obviously, you're from the Bowen family. Your family founded Honeydew Donuts, and you guys got a lot of great stores and also franchise owners, right?
Yes, absolutely. Thank you, Rob, for want to give a shout out to our shops in Rockland and Abington for helping us out, bringing the coffee and the cinnamon sticks during the South Shore Morning Tour. So thank you to them, Mike Russo in Rockland and Giovanni Savadini in Abington, and their wonderful staff.
I have to say, they're also so nice. Also, when I've gone into Rockland and Abington most recently, everybody's so nice. It's just a pleasure. It's a pleasure to go on into the store or drive through the drive-through. I just love being greeted by the cheery faces when I'm there. Maybe it helps that they're giving me some delicious coffee also, but what a treat.
Kara, I know you were also mentioning you wanted to mention some of those upcoming items.
Yeah, absolutely. So starting next week, the fall flavors are back. Us New Englanders, we love those warm notes of apple and cinnamon, and all reminds us of home. So starting next week, you can start seeing apple cider donuts in our stores. Maple coffee will be coming out, pumpkin muffins. We also have caramel apple cider, which is new for this year. So within the next couple weeks, you'll see those items making their way into stores. And we also have amazing new sandwich, a chorizo biscuit sandwich, which is just delicious, and it's a nice addition to our sandwich lineup, which is already pretty extensive. So
I don't know if I've ever asked you this in all the months we've been working together, but do you have a one single favorite item?
Oh, goodness.
I know. Hard to pick.
It is. That is a tough one to pick. I mean, I'm a sucker for a good muffin, but I'm also a sucker for a good donut. I mean, you sometimes a nice chocolate frosted with sprinkles, you can't go wrong.
All right. Well, Carrie, we're excited to have you here for the tour. We're going to have you down here till, I know you'll be here till 10 o'clock today, so people can come by, get the free cup of coffee and also the cinnamon sticks from Honeydew Donuts. And also, don't forget the WATD prize wheel is set up and it's activated as well. Oh, great to see former WATD alum over there just hopping over.
Steve.
It's Steve Dodrell. Hey, Steve.
Hey, Rob and Lisa. Great to be on the morning news. How are you guys?
How you been?
Fantastic. It's been 2.5 years since I've been on the WATD airwaves. Sad, huh?
You miss us and we miss you.
I miss you guys terribly, but I don't mean to interrupt your interview. Good luck and have a great day in Whitman, all right?
All right, thank you.
All right, great to have everyone stopping by today. We want to see you. We're going to be here till 10 o'clock today. Kara, thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, Kara's going to be here. And don't forget, too, we're going to have the WATD prize, where we're going to tell you about some of those prizes that are on there in just a few minutes.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour on 95.9 WATD. Now, live on the green in front of Whitman Town Hall, here's Rob Hakala and Lisa Azizian.
All right, good morning, everybody, and great, good to see you out here. Welcome to Friday. Here we are. This is the final Friday of the month, and as you know, we take the program out on the road on the final Friday of the month, and we're here in Whitman, Lisa, and this is a lot of fun. We want to thank Honeydew Donuts. We got the delicious hot coffee and the cinnamon sticks for you free, so come on down. We're outside Whitman Town Hall on the green here, and it's just gorgeous outside today.
Yeah, and I've been on the prize wheel this morning, and we want to hear it some more, so come on down and take your chance. You could win anything from great t-shirts and frisbees, all the way to really, really cool gift certificates from a lot of wonderful local Whitman businesses.
All right. And, you know, one of the other great stories we're going to hear about the town of Whitman is Sarah is with us today. Her name is Sarah Bennett. She is a Whitman mom, and she reached out and said, hey, there's a very cool story here about Whitman involving some great kids that are doing something very special. Sarah, good morning.
Good morning, Rob and Lisa. Thanks for having us.
Thanks for coming down and being with us today. So tell us this story again about what's going on, and then we'll introduce who's here with us.
We had five local kids from the Whitman community who train at the Tama Dojo here in town who decided to compete on the national circuit to earn a chance to represent Team USA at the World Karate Championships.
Wow.
So,
that's amazing.
So all these kids competed really hard, they stepped up their training, and they traveled to Ohio in March, where they all won national spots to compete to earn a spot, and then they went back to Detroit in June, and five of the kids will now be going to Orlando, Florida to compete on the world level.
And my word!
That's amazing.
Wow.
And we have two of the five kids here, I believe. We've got Matthew and also Zachary as well. So Matthew and Zachary, good morning to you.
Good morning.
All right, you guys pretty excited?
Yep.
All right, now tell us about, you know, how long have you been doing this?
I've been doing karate for 5 years.
6 years.
Wow, okay. And you guys are pretty excited to be going to this national level?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Now, but obviously, I think one of the things that are involved is that you need to raise some money in order for this to happen. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, so how does it work? What are you doing, and what can people do to help you?
We are selling chocolates, and we're just collecting donations from people.
All right, so if people are listening this morning from the Whitman area and they want to help you guys achieve your goal here to represent Team USA, how can they buy these chocolates? Or Sarah, what's a good way to help out these boys?
So the town has been really great with allowing the kids opportunities to fundraise. We did a couple concert series this summer in July and August. We've had some other events planned through some local crafters, and the DARE program is going to be having a car show in October, and they're going to be allowing the kids to fundraise there as well. So the town has reached out and been really great with helping to get these kids to their goal. We also set up a bank account at the Mutual Bank here in Whitman, and it's under the account Whitman Team USA, if anybody would like to make a donation. And the kids have been working hard representing the team, representing the town, and we wish them luck and hope to get them there to compete and do well.
Where might I
find this chocolate that you speak of?
Oh, we brought two bags of samples for you. One of our local moms makes them and has been busily in the kitchen making sure that these kids have them to sell, to have the opportunity to get there.
That is amazing. All right, well, we wish you guys the best of luck. What was the competition like when you were in Ohio?
Pretty tough.
Yeah, it was pretty tough.
All right, you feel ready? You feel ready to take on the next challenge?
Yeah.
All right, well, we're pretty excited. Okay, so again, Sarah, what's the best way for people to help out?
The Mutual Bank here in Whitman, there's an account for the kids listed under Whitman Team USA. Any funds donated would go towards all five competitors and help to defray the costs of equipment, gear, and the expense to get them there for their trip.
All right, how close are you guys within reach of this goal, Sarah?
We are getting there, but any donation, big or small, would greatly help us to get them there even further.
All right, well, we want to help out, and thank you guys again for representing just a great story about Whitman and getting these kids to their goals, because they've worked so very hard to get to this point. Sarah, thank you so much, and I want to thank Matthew and Zachary, and also we got Joe over there, one of the dads as well. So thank you guys all for coming out, and thank you for this lovely gift as well, and go Whitman.
Thank you very much. Have a great day.
You too.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour on 95.9 WATD. Now, live on the green in front of Whitman Town Hall, here's Rob Hakala and Lisa Azizian.
And good morning. Here we are. We are coming to you live from Whitman. Yes, we are outside Whitman Town Hall on a beautiful Friday as we are once again doing the South Shore Morning Tour. This is actually our final stop, and it's been great to have so many people coming out in the 6 o'clock hour. I can't believe it's already 7:11 now, Lisa.
I know. It's been so nice to meet new faces and see the kids that are here and just say hi to everybody. Thank you for all the beeping when you drive by. But stop on by. Their parking space is right here in front of the town hall. You can pull in, and you can come say hi. You've got to spin that prize wheel and, of course, grab that cup of coffee from Honeydew Donuts.
This is great, yeah. We've got the Honeydew coffee and those delicious cinnamon sticks that I was snacking on during the 7 o'clock news. So come on down and see us today. Lots of free items. So it's free. It's a beautiful Friday morning. And again, enjoy it as we get ready to wrap out the month of August. Well, the 7 o'clock hour is sponsored by our good friends over at Instabright. And we're going to be chatting right now with Dave Friedman. He is with us from Instabright. And we're going to talk about all the things that Instabright can do for your home. They're online at Instabright.com. That's Insta, B-R-I-T-E.com. And did you know the world headquarters for Instabright is located in the beautiful town of Whitman? Dave, good morning.
Good morning.
Great to have you here. It was great because I was here, you know, we were getting ready to do the show, and during the course of the program, several big Instabright trucks came by and were honking their horns.
Yeah, they're on their way out.
This is great. Okay, well, Instabright, tell us about your business, Dave, and what you do and what Instabright is all about for those of us that don't know.
So Instabright, we're a pretty big company that washes houses, buildings, heavy equipment, fleets of trucks, all those sorts of things.
Okay. Now, I know, Lisa, you have some personal experience with Instabright because I think it was before, was it the bridal shower?
Yeah, the bridal shower. The year was 2013, and it was being hosted, my shower, at my parents' house. I fondly call it the Azizian compound, where we all gather together. And my father, God love him, in his 70s, wanted to get up on the ladder and power wash the house. And we said, you cannot do that. You cannot do that. And he said, give me the number for Instabright. And I thought, this is working. See,
he
listens every day.
Yeah.
And he knows who to call. So thank you so much. It looked amazing.
Excellent. Yeah.
It was beautiful. So that's something that you can do for the exterior of your home. And Dave, I think you were saying that actually, just as getting the lawn reseeded, this is the perfect time to take care of that, right? So tell us why specifically this is a good time of year to do that.
Well, everybody thinks about spring is the best time to clean, and we're obviously very, very busy in the spring, but we're as busy washing houses in the fall as we are in the spring, because the mildew and mold are not growing in the fall, and then people start thinking about getting ready for the holidays, getting their house looking perfect, and so we're very, very busy in September and October washing homes and roofs and decks and all that.
What I love, too, is you don't have to be home. You can schedule this appointment and you just close those windows and you're good to go. You can go on about doing your errands or go to work for the day.
That's absolutely right. All people have to do is call the office, typically right over the phone. I can ask them a bunch of questions about what they want to get done and the specifics of their house. We agree on a price. Then my brother-in-law, Greg, is the scheduler. So he'll get the write-up, and then he'll call the folks and say, we'll be there on Thursday morning. You don't need to be home. Just make sure all the windows are closed. We'll do a very good job. And then if you're happy, you pay us.
Great. And it's easy as that, just calling and talking about what people need, setting a price, and boom, you're done.
That's it. And we can wash the roof, the house, the deck, whatever, the fencing, whatever you need.
Oh, the fencing. Oh, that's yeah. That's something people might not always think about. You know, I've seen a lot of those beautiful white plastic fences turning green.
That's it. They turn green, and a lot of people use well water to water their lawns, and a lot of times there are the hard water stains, the orange stains that get on people's houses, vinyl houses, and on the fencing, and that can be all be removed safely.
Mm. That's great. And that can that extend the life, I imagine, and try to stop the fence or the product from you know, eroding sooner?
Deteriorating, absolutely.
Yeah.
You know, mold accumulation and all kinds of things that get on surfaces can start creating more rot, and that's why we clean.
Right.
You know, plus it's something people should think about too, is if they're putting the house on the market. You know, a lot of people are talking about housing and for putting the house up for sale. Make that appointment now and get that done to really, really, what is it, curb appeal as they
curb
call
appeal.
It?
Curb appeal. The realtors love us, exactly. We're one of the first people the realtors suggest that that folks call us, because for pretty low investment, you can make the house look really, really good. The roof, the front of the house, the walkways, the retaining walls, it can all be very clean very easily.
All right, Dave Friedman's the guy to get in touch with, InstaBright. He can take care of your home. Dave, again, how can people get in touch with you so that we can get started?
781-447-0022.
All right, InstaBright.com, InstaBright.com. Dave Friedman's going to be here. He's sponsoring the 7 o'clock hour. Again, their world headquarters located here in Whitman, so a local business, and they'd be happy to help you out. Dave, thanks for sponsoring the tour.
Thank you very much.
It's what's new now. The South Shore's Morning News with Rob and Lisa on 95.9 WATD.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour.
Coming to you from beautiful Whitman on this Friday morning, the 28th of August. Great to have you here, and we'd love to see you in person as well. This hour of the Morning Tour is sponsored by InstaBright. You want to find out how to get the exterior of your house clean before winter hits? We'll stop by outside Whitman Town Hall, 7 to 8. Meet Dave Friedman from InstaBright. Dave can answer all your questions about how InstaBright cleans the exterior of your home to get rid of all that nasty grime. You won't believe the difference. Go to InstaBright.com, InstaBright.com, to see before and after pictures of what InstaBright can do for your home. Good morning, Lisa.
Good morning, Rob. Well, in the first hour of the broadcast, we heard quite a bit of history of Whitman, but related to the Toll House cookie. But we wanted to bring in Historical Commission Chair Marie Lehler to talk about more of Whitman history. Marie, it's a lot to cover, but where should we start?
It is. Well, I think my first request to you all is that we do meet every third Tuesday at 7 o'clock here at the Town Hall. And anybody that is interested in any historical areas, please come see us. We have a lot of resource materials. The Whitman Town Hall and the Whitman Library also have resource materials.
Great.
So please come visit with us. We're always looking for interested parties.
Okay, great.
But Whitman is fantastic. It has a Frederick Law Olmsted design town park. He's the same landscape architect that put together the Emerald Necklace up in Boston,
sure.
The Boston Common. It's just an amazing place. Some of the other things that's going on is the Mass Historical Commission has just awarded us a grant.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. And we are going to be doing surveys of historical resources within the town.
Mm.
So we're in the process. We've put out the request for proposals. We've gotten proposals back. And next week we're meeting to sit and actually go through them and make a decision on who is going to come in and do historical surveys for the town.
Okay, wow, that's exciting.
So it's pretty exciting. It's going to really landmark some of the things that we need to have put together.
Okay.
Our town hall was actually put together in 1907, and we would like to see that registered on the National Historical Register.
Mm-hmm.
So the first step would be this survey and getting it onto the Mass Historical.
Oh, I see. Okay, wonderful. I was reading a little bit about Whitman history. It was first part of Abington, wasn't it?
We were way back, way back when we were actually called South Abington. And in 1886, we voted to become our own little place.
And break out on your own.
We broke out on our own. And it's funny because we could have been called Grandin, Healyville. There were a couple of other choices, but the name Whitman won out. So in 1886, we were finally incorporated as the town of Whitman.
Oh, what other tidbit can you share with us that may not be common knowledge for our listeners?
Well, many years ago, there was a Boston Post cane historical item. And what happened with that is that it was presented to the oldest citizen living within the town.
Oh, so like a walking cane?
Well, it's like a walking cane, but it's more of an honor to be presented with it. And we are currently trying to get that program back up and running.
Oh.
So it's presented to the oldest citizen, and then when they pass on, it is received back by the town.
Mm-hmm.
And then present it again to the next oldest citizen.
Ah, interesting.
So that will be sort of fun to get going again.
I like the pageantry of that.
Yes, absolutely. And they'll have a plaque and the whole bit.
Ah.
It's a fun thing.
Oh, well, thank you for sharing. I know there's so much more we can get into, but I appreciate this slice of Whitman history.
Not a problem.
And when do you meet again? We can remind
people. We meet on the third Tuesday of the month at 7 o'clock in the second floor of the town hall. The meetings are posted on the post board in the town hall lobby.
Oh, thank you so much, Marie, from the Historical Commission, Marie
Thank
Layla.
You, Marie.
We appreciate your time.
Thank you.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour on 95.9 WATD. Now, live on the green in front of Whitman Town Hall, here's Rob Hakala and Lisa Azizian.
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah, here we are. We are back. It is great to be here in the beautiful town of Whitman. Great to see so many people coming by, and it is just wonderful to have such great support from the town of Whitman. And we're going to be with you until 10 o'clock today, and this hour of the Morning Tour is sponsored by Instabright. Do you want to find out how to get the exterior of your house clean before winter hits? Well, stop by Whitman Town Hall this morning from 7 to 8 to meet Dave Friedman from Instabright. Dave can answer all your questions about how Instabright cleans the exterior of your home to get rid of all that nasty grime. You won't believe the difference. Go to Instabright.com to see before and after pictures of what Instabright can do for your home. And don't forget, too, we're also being simulcast on Whitman Hanson Community Access Channel 12. Thank you very much, Whitman Hanson Access, for simulcasting today's South Shore Morning Tour. We've got free coffee. We've got free cinnamon sticks from Honeydew Donuts, so stop on by and pick up some delicious free coffee and cinnamon sticks to start your Friday morning as we are celebrating the great town of Whitman. We can hear the commuter rail in the distance here on this beautiful, sunny Friday morning. Also, don't forget plenty of great prizes on the WATD prize wheel. Lisa will tell us more about that coming up. But first, I believe we have the selectman chair here in the town of Whitman. Dr. Carl Kowalski is with us. Doctor, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Doing very well. Nice to meet you, and thanks for coming down to the program today. Well, it is great to see you. So, you know, we're highlighting just this beautiful town of Whitman. We learned last half hour a bit more about its history. Coming up later on, we're going to chat with the police chief and the fire chief and the current state rep, Jeff Deal. So tell us a bit about how you got involved in town government and perhaps some personal stories about what you love most about Whitman.
Well, my wife and I moved to Whitman in 1972. I got a job at Massasoit Community College then. Started off teaching English. I ended up being an administrator for almost 40 years. Retired a few years ago. And we found a little house in Whitman, and we've moved once since then.
Yeah.
Stayed in Whitman. It's been a great town. We have two children who are now 38 and 43, and it was a beautiful place to bring them up. They both went to Whitman Hanson High School and enjoyed it.
Oh, that's great. So you guys really just fell in love with the town early and just ended up staying here.
Yes, we did. I actually had a connection to the town prior to that. My great uncle was the fire chief in Whitman in the 1920s.
Oh wow!
His name was Bert Dyer, and he lived in the corner of South Avenue and Dyer Avenue in a little house down there with pillars. And he was a big part of Whitman way back then. And I can remember as a child, I grew up in Weymouth, as a child coming to his house to play on occasion. And so I had that little bit of a connection anyway beforehand.
What are some of the reasons you wanted to get involved in being part of the Board of Selectmen here, and perhaps some of the issues that you feel you really wanted to tackle?
Well, I started off years ago in the early 80s on the Historical Commission. And learned some interesting things there from a man who's dead now by the name of Russell Gardner, who was a piece of work. He could trace his family back to the Wampanoags in Plymouth.
Oh, wow.
And also to the Mayflower. Hmm. And he spoke in a Wampanoag dialect when he wanted to. And he could, every Thanksgiving down at Plymouth Plantation, he would recite the Lord's Prayer in the dialect of the ancient Wampanoags, and he was on the Historical Commission at the time. And
wow, what a great resource.
He was psyched about the history of Whitman, and I learned three things from him then. That Whitman was basically known for three things. Maybe you've heard this already.
Tell us.
You know about the Toll House cookie, obviously.
Yeah, we did.
And the fact that Cardinal Spellman was born and raised in Whitman.
Oh, wow, okay.
He actually had played baseball for the Whitman high school baseball team, if I remember correctly. And also there was a man by the name of Aaron Hobart, who taught Hobart's Pond, who taught Paul Revere how to cast spells.
Yeah.
So I learned those three things and from Russell, and I'll never forget them. But after I was on the Historical Commission for a couple of years, I ran for school committee. I had young children in the system and thought it would be a way to use...
How's that?
My connection to education and to serve the town, and I enjoyed that. I was on the school committee from 1984 to 1998. During the time when we were looking for a new school, we regionalized it during that period of time, joining Hanson to make it a K-12 system.
Mm-hmm.
And so I got involved in the town then, and then I took a few years off, and in 2002, ran for selectman, and I've been there ever since, and greatly enjoyed it.
What are some of the things that you would love for people to know about the town of Whitman? You know, maybe why it's a great place to move to. What are some things, maybe if we don't live here, that we should see, just to kind of highlight?
Yeah.
Well, the park is unique in a way. You probably have heard that the park was designed by Olmsted, the famous emerald necklace person from. From Boston and from other places, Central Park in New York, etc. It's got a feel of a town in the 1950s. It's almost like going back to Leave It to Beaver City to live in this town. And it reminds me of growing up in Weymouth when I was a kid. I grew up in Weymouth in the 50s.
Yeah.
And this town reminded me of that, and it has maintained that character.
That's great, and you love that feeling today. Wow, Dr. Carl Kowalski, thank you so much. You're the current... Selectman Chair, the Board of Selectmen here in the town of Whitman, and sharing some personal stories and just how great this community is. And I want to thank you for coming out and being part of our morning tour highlighting this town.
Okay, you're welcome. Thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Carl Kowalski.
It's what's new now. The South Shore's Morning News with Rob and Lisa on 95.9 WATD.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour.
And we are coming to you from beautiful Whitman. Good morning. Thank you so much for being here with us today, whether you're listening in your car or at home or are here on the green right outside in front of Whitman Town Hall. Great to see so many people out here this morning since 6 o'clock as we celebrate and highlight this wonderful community of Whitman. This hour of the morning tour is sponsored by Instabright. Thank you, Instabright. Stop by Whitman Town Hall this morning to meet Dave Friedman from Instabright. Dave can answer all your questions about how Instabright cleans the exterior of your home to get rid of all that nasty grime. You won't believe the difference. Go to Instabright.com, Instabright.com to see before and after pictures of what Instabright can do for your home. Lisa Azizian, good morning to you and welcome.
Good morning. Well, Rob, this portion of the program, we wanted to bring in Chief of Police Scott Benton to join us this morning. Chief, I'm going to have you just pull up a little closer to the microphone. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Doing great. Well, we've been learning so much about Whitman today, the great history, what makes it special. How long have you been part of Whitman? How part of you, part of the community here?
My father bought our first house in 1967 on Kendrick Street. Mm. I think it was $4,500.
Oh.
So, yeah.
Yeah, very different today.
Yeah, that's for sure.
What makes Whitman special?
You know, I think the uniqueness that is Whitman is that everybody seems to know everybody or knows somebody who knows that person. Mm. And you don't get that nowadays. You know, it's nice to walk downtown or you're in the supermarket or wherever you may be and you have a tie to somebody. And that makes you, you know, invested in that community. And Whitman has always done great by the youth. Mm. When I grew up, I mean, we had street hockey leagues, baseball, soccer, football. I mean, it was, you know, and I mean, when I say like supporters of that, parents that came out, you know, gave their time, I mean, coaches, it's just a great community. It always has been.
Can you tell us a little bit about what's on sort of your radar these days? What are some of the important initiatives for the police department as we kind of wrap up the summer here in 2015, head into the fall?
Sure. You know, like most communities and across the country right now, there's certainly some hot topic buttons. You know, you'll hear a lot of banter about body cameras, mm-hmm. Cameras for within the cruises and stuff. A lot of pros and cons. It's real easy for somebody to throw out, hey, throw a camera on, and, you know, and we're covered. And I think one of the things that I don't like, besides a couple technical things that I'll tell you, is it's almost, we have assumed that the police in this country, there's a move to say, we don't do our job, or we don't do our job the right way, so we have to double check them the whole time. Mm. And I think that that's dangerous, because less than half of 1% of all law enforcement in the world ever do anything to discredit that badge. Yeah. Mm. So I take exception to that. I know it's not a popular thing to speak out about, but I think that some of us need to do that because, you know, that message needs to be sent. That said, you know, where the camera is, if I put that camera on my chest, mm-hmm. it isn't seeing what my eyes are seeing.
Right.
It's seeing the view from my chest. So, you know, I may see something that the camera doesn't pick up.
Right, it's just one point of view.
It's one point. Also, the camera has 20/20 vision. Underneath the streetlight at 2 in the morning with a subject that is exhibiting aggressive behavior, I might see that flash from mm-hmm. his pants that he's pulling something out. It may be a phone, but I might not see it as a phone. I may see it as another object, but the camera may see it. Oh yeah, that was a phone. Why didn't mm-hmm. you do that? Mm-hmm. So, you know, I just think, and those aren't the only things, but those are some highlights. I think there's a thing where the police need to have them almost on their glasses.
So, sure.
In other words, you'd wear safety glasses to weed whack your yard. A police officer would almost have to have on those glasses with the camera mounted to the glasses.
Yeah. Interesting.
All right. Okay. Well, it's been great to chat with you, Police Chief. Again, thank you so much, Scott Benton, for being with us today.
All right. Thank you.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour on 95.9 WATD. Now, live on the green in front of Whitman Town Hall, here's Rob Hakala and Lisa Azizian.
All right, here we are, and it is our number 3 as we are coming to you from the beautiful town of Whitman. We are outside Whitman Town Hall here on Route 27, and we want to see you out here today as we are wrapping up the South Shore Morning Tour 2015. And also, by the way, for all our friends watching, good morning to you. Whitman Hanson Community Access, Channel 12. Thank you for simulcasting the South Shore Morning Tour on this final day of August. It is the final Friday in August, the 28th. And that's what we do. We take the program out on the road on the final Friday of every month. We started out the tour this year in our town of Hanover, and then we went to Weymouth and Marshfield, and now we're here in Whitman, outside Whitman Town Hall. And it's great to be here, and there's still plenty of free hot coffee. Kara Bowen is here from Honeydew Donuts. Good morning. And don't forget still to try any cinnamon sticks still left, Kara, as well.
Oh, yeah.
Those delicious cinnamon sticks, get those over there as well. It's all free today. And the prize wheel as well. See Ryan over there and take a chance and spin the prize wheel. And also, Lisa, there's a great... you'll see a paint can, mm-hmm. and people should stop by and put their name in there, right?
They should, because we are giving away not one, but two pairs of tickets to King Richard's Fair. It's
King
coming.
King Richard's Fair.
Yes, a hallmark of September. It's coming September 5th, and you could win. All you need to do is put your name in that paint can.
Oh, that's a great value.
And right around 9:45 or so, we'll pull the winners' names. Two pairs today to King Richard's Fair. And don't forget all those great gift certificates right there also on the prize wheel from places like McGuigan's Pub, Uncle David, Supreme Pizza, Duval's Pharmacy, Venus Cafe, Regal Marketplace, Diamond Fuel, and so many more.
All right. Well, we want to see you down here. And in order to win those prizes, you're going to spin the prize wheel. And also be sure before 9:45 to put your name in for those King Richard's Fair tickets. But you got to put your name in before 9:45. This hour of the Morning Tour, sponsored by McLaughlin Chevrolet. And we want to invite you to come on down here between the 8 and 9 hour. You can meet this famous guy, the ops manager, Dan Adams. He's here, right here. I just got his autograph during the 8 o'clock news. Find out how McLaughlin has remained one of the oldest family-owned Chevy dealerships, not on the South Shore, not in New England, but in the United States. They're located at 741 Temple Street, Route 27, here in the beautiful town of Whitman, and they've been servicing Whitman and the surrounding communities since 1922. And Dan, good morning to you, and thank you for sponsoring our 8 o'clock hour.
Good morning, Rob. Thanks for having me. And did you say famous or infamous? I wasn't really sure.
Either
one
way.
One of those does apply, but we'll... we'll let my old friends decide that.
Well, it's good to have you here. And tell us about McLaughlin Chevrolet, because obviously it's got a long tie to this community.
Well, it does. It's a very unique dealership. It's one of the oldest family-owned Chevrolet dealerships in the country. It's still run by third-generation Paul McLaughlin from Scituate. And we run it like a family business. I know that sounds ad nauseum to a lot of people. We're not a large dealership. We don't want to be a big dealership. We want to be a small dealership. We want everyone to walk through that door and recognize someone and know them by their first name. Mm. It makes them feel comfortable, and it makes it feel like they don't have to buy something from us.
Yeah.
But they can get the information they need on a comfortable level, and they can make their own decisions. And that's how we run our business. And obviously we're doing something right, because we've been doing it for almost 95 years.
Yeah, that says something, and it tells that you really do have a long tie and that you're doing the right thing, and you guys do a great business. And also you talk about, yeah, it is nice to know that it's a local tie when you're making a big purchase like that and buying a car, that you can talk to people that you know that are right here from the area, and it's not one of these huge chain of dealerships.
That's true. And, you know, our advertising expenditures are minimal, because most of our business is repeat and referral business. People refer people to us because they're comfortable. And that's what we strive for. Even though we're a small dealership, we're actually a large dealership. We're one of the largest wholesale parts distributors in the state. We deliver about $7 million worth of wholesale parts to independent garages from Boston to P-Town, everywhere in between. So we have a structure at the dealership that helps keep costs down. We divide the cost of doing business amongst our different departments. So we can be competitive with, I don't care how big another dealer is, we can be competitive with anybody.
Wow.
What would that small dealership feel?
Wow. Okay. I didn't know that. Interesting.
How about servicing, that kind of side?
Well, service is, you know, we have, again, probably 80-90% repeat service business. But we also handle the largest fleets in the state. I personally handle the largest utilities in New England. And we service and deliver them parts also. And then once we establish relationships with those companies, their employees come and buy vehicles for themselves too. So as a business acumen, we can cover all our bases, from the one-on-ones to the independent garages to some of the largest fleet companies in New England. So we got our bases covered.
Mm. That's pretty cool. Okay, well, I guess you wanted to maybe talk about some of those cars, Lisa?
I know. I'm curious. Well, what are the 2016s out yet on the lot?
They're starting to land. We just actually had a 2016 Z06 Corvette land a couple weeks ago. It was a factory order sold for a gentleman, and he had to wait till the temperature rose above 55 degrees to drive the car. The tires are so specialized on that car that they the the ground has to be over 55 degrees.
Yeah. Wow. Okay.
Wow.
Are there specials? So the 2016s are rolling in, then are there specials on maybe getting the 2015s out the door?
Yeah, there are. This is a good time. This is probably the best time of the year to buy cars. It used to be in September and October when the manufacturers put their big deals on. Mm-hmm. They don't anymore. It's in August and early September. So we cleaned out our inventory, so we ordered a lot of the new product for the factory. So the Chevy Cruze has been a fantastic seller for us. One of the safest cars on the road. Great first car for someone. The lease deals on those are incredible. You know, in the $100 range, high, you know, mid hundreds. Mm-hmm. The Malibu's a great car. We have a new Malibu coming in 2016. Mm. The Impala, you hear a lot about the Impala. It's one of the best designed, highest rated car Consumer Reports ever gave to any vehicle ever made.
Wow.
It's a Chevrolet Impala.
Wow, that's great.
And of course, the Silverado.
Yeah.
Speak for itself. And the new Chevy Colorado, we're typically on a 15-day supply, which means they're selling as soon as we get them.
Oh, my gosh.
It's a great little truck.
Wow. Yeah. Okay.
All right. So if people want to come down and meet you, Dan, and the rest of the great staff, take a look down there. You invite people to do that. Easy to get to right there in Route 27 on Temple Street, right?
Yep, Route 27, 741 Temple Street, McLaughlinChevy.com. And if I could, before we go, I want to say hello to my wife, Carol, and my special little boy, Daniel, who I believe is listening. And, you know, Dr. Kowalski was just here talking about the history of Whitman.
Yeah.
And maybe some people have heard the ad that I put on. It is such a unique, small community. Mm-hmm. Now, it's an old part of Abington.
Yeah.
It used to be South Abington. But, you know, some of the other things about Whitman is the Constitution. The timber for the USS Constitution was milled. Sourced and milled right here in Whitman.
Right.
That's
now, I told that story in Chicago around a group of eight men, and they had tears in their eyes. We take it for granted the history that we walk on in around this area.
Yeah.
For all the whole South Shore, and even in Boston.
That's
so and actually, that was right behind our house. I just had a conversation with Dr. Kowalski. The pond that fed the mill was right behind our house. Simmons Ave is where Dr. Kowalski and I live. We're neighbors. And it's still there. People,
right.
Well, people take it for granted.
Would you take a tour of the ship? Think about Whitman.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, yep. I love the South Shore.
Oh, and if anyone comes down today yep. and can answer any trivia questions about the town of Whitman and McLaughlin Chevrolet, I'm going to leave some T-shirts here to give away for any listeners who want to come down today and visit the rest of the show. And if they can answer a trivia question, I'll leave some of them for you. They're more than welcome to get a free T-shirt.
All right.
Thank you so much. All right. That's Dan Adams. He's Ops Manager, McLaughlin Chevrolet. Check him out. 741 Temple Street, Route 27 in Whitman. They're sponsoring our 8 o'clock hour. Dan, thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour on 95.9 WATD. Now, live on the green in front of Whitman Town Hall, here's Rob Hakala and Lisa Azizian.
Oh, yeah, here we are in beautiful Whitman. Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. We got a great crowd out here. We're celebrating and highlighting this beautiful town of Whitman today here on this final Friday in August, if you can believe it. And, you know, we started the tour, Lisa, in our hometown of Hanover, and we headed to Weymouth, and we did Marshfield, and we said last but not least, certainly, the town of Whitman. We wanted to be here, and thank you so much to the town of Whitman for letting us do the program here on the front lawn of this beautiful Whitman Town Hall where we are today, and we're so happy to be here. This hour of the morning tour is sponsored by McLaughlin Chevrolet. Stop by and meet Ops Manager Dan Adams and find out how McLaughlin has remained one of the oldest family-owned Chevy dealerships in the United States. And they're at 741 Temple Street, Route 27 here in Whitman, and they've been servicing this area since 1922. So check them out online, McLaughlinChevy.com. Thank you so much for sponsoring the 8 o'clock hour. A great local business. And we're highlighting the town of Whitman, and we're inviting you to stop on down today because we still have plenty of free coffee. Kara Bowen is here from Honeydew Donuts, and we've got the hot coffee there. And also, Ryan is over at the WATD Prize Wheel. Spin the prize wheel, and you could walk away a winner. There's still lots of great items on there. And also, Lisa, you got to put your name in for the King Richard's Fair tickets, because
right.
we're going to be pulling those out about 9:45. So
yeah.
if you want to go to King Richard's Fair,
two pairs,
you got to put your name in the bin, right?
Mm-hmm. It's true. Easy to do. Actually, there's a line right there in front of the paint can. Two tickets. So we have two pairs of tickets, so we're going to pull two names, get that 222, two names at around 9:45 this morning. You still have time to come on down and put that name of yours into that paint can.
And by the way, too, we also want to thank Whitman Hanson Community Access. We're simulcasting the program today, Channel 12. So good morning to everyone that's watching on Whitman Hanson Community Access. Thank you so much. And everyone else who's listening, thank you. And we're going to welcome in our next guest here. He is the current state rep for Whitman in Abington and East Bridgewater. His name is Jeff Deal. He's a Whitman resident, and he's with us right here as part of the morning tour. Jeff, good morning to you.
Hey, Rob, Lisa, thanks for having me on.
Thanks for coming down here. You were just telling us off air that this is a community you are very proud of.
It is. I mean, you said it's last on the list, but it's the first in my heart because it's where I live, but also my wife grew up here. It's a great town. You know, you really see a great community here that comes out. A lot of people here, of course, celebrating you guys being here. But honestly, it's one of those towns that's a bedroom community. People get up, go to work, and they really contribute back, and they volunteer a lot. You know, my wife's... she's actually the runs Whitman Youth Cheerleading, and so many parents that help volunteer and be a part of that are great. A lot of pride in this town, Panther pride, and you know, the other thing too is you see a lot of great businesses in this town, and businesses who sponsored you coming here, just a lot of businesses that really have done a great job making our downtown look great, run well, employ a lot of people. So, you know, it's a great town to be from, and I love it.
Yeah, that was Selectman Chair Dr. Carl Kowalski was talking about. He felt that this is kind of still a town that's got a little bit of that 1950s feel, in that it's really just that what you think of as a nice small town that's a great place to raise a family.
Yeah, and that's the thing. You know, whether you're in retirement here in Whitman, or whether you're a young family that's raising children, it's got everything. It's got the restaurants, it's got the stores, it's got the places to work. Surrounding towns, you know, are great to go to work at too. You're very close to the Cape, you know, if you want to go there. Very close to Boston if you want to go see the city and entertainment. So really, I think people who call Whitman home are some of the luckiest people on the South Shore.
Well, it really is a great place, and I am so excited to be here on what a great day it is.
I know,
it's
just
beautiful and gorgeous, and this town hall really is beautiful, and you know, I really never thought about it, but just sitting in its midst, this is just great here as we take a look over the town hall. And you were also talking, Jeff, that you got your early start in politics by being fueled by the power of Venus Pizza.
It is, right, we're sitting right across from Venus. And actually, Town Hall, I used to be on the Finance Committee here in Whitman, and that's really, you know, where I learned about the budgets, the way that the town ran, you know, all the line items. And then after we would have our Finance Committee meetings, we would go across the street sometimes to the Venus, have a salad, maybe talk and shoot the breeze. And that's kind of when, at the time, there was some grumbling about how the state had been cutting local aid and cutting Chapter 90 and Chapter 70 funds for education, things like that. And so, you know, I started thinking about maybe trying to make a difference in running for office. I ultimately decided to, and I think it was probably over Venus Pizza that we made that call.
And he's been going ever since.
I should give him a pizza after you, Jeff.
No, that's okay. It'd be a very plain pizza. That's for sure.
The deal. All right, now, Jeff, so tell us, I mean, obviously you've been doing a great job so far. You've been really enjoying your time as state rep, but there are some other things I know that you're working on and would like to do as far as a future in politics.
Yeah, so... very unfortunately, there was a passing of the current state senator for this district, Tom Kennedy, who had worked very hard for many years from the city of Brockton, who had, you know, done a great job representing this Senate district, which includes Brockton plus seven other towns, and including Whitman. And you know, I'm currently a state representative, have been for 5 years, and you know, since I've been elected, I've been working what I think is to try to keep, you know, money in the households, do a better job of being a watchdog on Beacon Hill about the waste that spending they're doing. You know, last year I was the chairman of the ballot question one to repeal the gas tax going up without a vote.
Tanking that, yeah.
Yeah, and I mean, we saved taxpayers about $2 billion that really we proved ultimately wasn't necessary because they actually had the funds up on Beacon Hill. Mm-hmm. And then this last year, the most important thing I think we put in was I filed language in the House to stop taxpayers from having to pay for the Olympic overruns. They wanted to...
Yeah. That was a huge victory for the people. And now, look what they're talking about out in L.A. now.
The discussion's very similar. I mean, can they really afford to have the Olympics there? And the problem is the Olympics model is such that, you know, they never really make enough to cover the cost of the Olympics. They haven't since 1960. And the overruns are so massive that it really would have been billions of dollars that taxpayers would have had to pay for that. So, you know, I filed a language in the House to have a taxpayer protection against those overruns. And then we ended up getting a coalition of people together, and we filed language with the Secretary of State. And about a week later, the Boston 2024 folks decided not to pursue the Olympics in Boston. So I think we dodged a bullet there. I mean, it would have been great to have Olympics, but on the other hand, you really have to think about the cost of it all.
Yeah, really. And people wonder, you know, really, is this the best use of our money at this time when people feel that the, you know, schools and infrastructure and transportation, all that needs to be addressed first. And I think ultimately the people did win.
Well, you know, there's a news report you guys had just, I don't know, at the top of the hour, I think, about healthcare costs rising for about 300,000 more residents of Massachusetts.
Yeah.
We need money to take care of the basic necessities for ourselves, and that's, I think, what we got to do up on Beacon Hill. I want to bring that mentality into the Senate with a special election. It's November 3rd, and I do have a website that I'm, you know, letting people know about.
Go ahead, tell us.
It's jeffdeal.com, www.jeffdeal.com. It's G-E-O-F-F-D-I-E-H-L.com. My mom decided to somehow make my life more interesting with a spelling of that first name.
It's memorable.
It is memorable, right?
All right, now, Jeff, we're just about out of time here, so you want to give a shout out to your family before we wrap it up?
Oh, gosh. Actually, yesterday was the first day of school, so I'm sure a lot of parents here already have put their kids on the buses. My kids were no exception. Yeah. And of course, my daughters, Kaylee and Emily, are now in eighth grade and fourth grade, respectively, so they should be studying right now. And my wife, Kathy Jo, is off to work at Boss Academy in Hanson, where she owns a performing arts school. So thanks to my family, who really makes, you know, my work in public life possible.
It's the state rep, Jeff Deal, from the town of Whitman. Jeff, thank you so much.
Thanks, Rob. Lisa.
It's what's new now. The South Shore's Morning News with Rob and Lisa on 95.9 WATD.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour.
And we are coming to you from the front lawn here at Whitman Town Hall on this beautiful Friday morning. It is the final Friday in August, 8:56. Rob and Lisa here with you till 10 o'clock. It's the South Shore Morning Tour, and we're going to bring in, this is great to learn more about the history of Whitman, a local business owner, Richard Rosen, is with us, third generation Whitman resident, and also known as the mayor of Whitman. Richard, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Doing very well. Good to have you here on WATD. So you've got a lot of history, I guess, when it comes to the town of Whitman. This is where your family has been for all these years.
Yeah, third generation. We've been here since 1898.
That's great.
We've been here for a while.
Okay, so tell us, you're involved in, you've got a couple of local businesses, right? You're in real estate and also a restaurant?
I do. Rosen Realty, it'll be 30 years next year that I've been in business. And I also own McGuigan's Pub right up the street in Whitman Center.
Wow.
And we were talking a little bit about the business community here, especially right here in the center. It's such a strong, strong community.
You know, that's what one of the things that make Whitman such an amazing small town is that the vibrant downtown area. We have a center. Most towns don't have a center.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And not only do we have a center, you know, and I've said it a million times, whether you like it or not, or whether you use it or not, we have it. There's something for everybody in Whitman Center, and it's almost always 100% occupied, all the businesses. I think there's one vacancy right now, and that's by choosing of the landlord, but it's a vibrant community, and it really is one of the things that makes Whitman great.
Because sometimes I get so sad when I maybe drive through like Weymouth Landing and other areas where there's all these empty storefronts, but that's not the case when you drive here.
No, not at all. I mean, I'm not going to stop mentioning other towns in the area, but, you know, there's some centers that have actually been deemed a blighted area because there's so few tenants in any of the buildings, but that's not the case in Whitman.
Well, that's great. What do you think some of the reasons are? Is it just support from the community to keep these businesses going?
No, I think that's part of it. And, you know, Whitman is a small town, and we offer a lot of great services. I mean, there's businesses. We can see Menard Jewelers. They've been there since, I think, 1946.
Wow.
Duval's Pharmacy has been there since around the same time. So a lot of these businesses have been here forever, and they all serve a different need. I mean, we have a couple of banks, and so, I mean, they all serve a different need, and people shop at them.
And you've been so active in the community for so long. I mean, as part of Winterfest for many years and the big New Year's Eve celebrations. And
yeah.
Talk about those events and what it means to you to help to create and sustain the community that way.
You know, I believe very much so in giving back. And if you have the ability to give back, that you really need to. And community involvement and volunteer services, that's, you know, extremely important to me. Winterfest was started, you know, we did it for 20 years.
Mm.
We don't have enough time for me to explain why it was started, but it's very, very rewarding to do those things.
Mm-hmm.
You know, to see you know, months and months and months of planning go into something that lasts a couple of hours. And it's very rewarding to see the looks on people's faces or whatever happens in the community. But, I mean, it's great. And that's, you know, one of the things that makes Whitman a great small town.
Richard Rosen, thank you so much. We're out of time already, but I want to thank Richard Rosen, third-generation Whitman resident, for joining us. Thank you, Richard.
Thank you.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour on 95.9 WATD. Now, live on the green in front of Whitman Town Hall, here's Rob Hakala and Lisa Azizian.
All right, everybody. Good morning, everybody, and welcome. And here we are. It is the fourth and final hour coming to you from Whitman here on the green in front of Town Hall. We do this every on the final Friday of every month. It's great to see everyone down here in Whitman. And thank you for coming out and inviting us to be in your community today. And we are so happy to be here on what is a beautiful Friday morning, Lisa. The weather certainly is gorgeous. Couldn't have asked for a better day. It is sunshine, low humidity, very comfortable, and just a perfect day to get out. And it's been so nice to see so many generations out here, Lisa. You know, different families, and we got kids out here. We've got adults, grandparents. It's just wonderful to see so many people coming out today and enjoying the coffee and the prize wheel, and it's just so fun.
Well, it's funny you say the word generations. Yes, because that also applies to the fact that we've learned so much about Whitman, and a lot of people stay in Whitman, multi-generational families, multi-generational businesses here in Whitman. It's a special community, and we've learned so much today, and definitely more to come in this hour of the broadcast.
All right, don't forget, too, we're going to be pulling out those names, Lisa, at 9:45
for the
tickets for King Richard's Fair, so tell us about that.
Yeah, we have two pairs of tickets that we're giving away, so you do have some more time, so when you come on down, it's next to the prize wheel, the paint can. All you do is fill out information, your name, your town, your phone number. We're going to pull your name at 9:45. If you're not here, I'll call you today and let you know you're the lucky winner. So we have got two pairs of tickets to the King Richard's Fair. And by the way, the fair opens in Carver September 5th.
All right, so come on down. We're going to be pulling out those names before 9:45. So if you want a chance to win those King Richard Fair tickets, you got to put your name into the bin. So come on up to the WATD prize wheel, put your name in the bin, and also spin the prize wheel, and you could walk away a winner from some great items. And Ryan is right over there, and he'll be happy to take care of you. 9 o'clock hour of the morning tour is sponsored by Smoke and Ashes. So they're one of our sponsors here to make the tour possible today. And we're going to talk about the different products that they sell. And if you'd like to enjoy a fine cigar during your time off, you need to stop by to Smoke and Ashes. The store manager from their Whitman store is on hand. We're going to talk about all the great imported and domestic cigars they carry at their store on Route 18 at 410 Bedford Street. You can check them out online at smokeandashestobacco.com. As we're talking a lot about Whitman businesses who have been sponsoring this tour today, Lulu Zhang and Joe Bellotta are with us today. Lulu and Joe, good morning to you, and thanks for coming out today in Whitman.
Thank you for having us.
All right, so tell us, you know, obviously we hear Smoke and Ashes, so tell us a bit about what you guys do and how long the store has been there, and a bit about what you want to discuss as far as being a local business.
We've been in business for about 30 years. Dave and Lisa, Brendan, the owners, started in Clear Square in Hyde Park, actually. So over the last 30 years or so, they've owned about 15 stores in the South Shore area. The Whitman store, we opened in 2013, and we're very lucky to have gotten that location. It's right on Route 18. It's 410 Bedford Street. We carry all different kind of premier cigars, we e-cigarettes, e-juices, and we also carry all sorts of different flavored hookahs and hookah accessories and all sorts of other accessories that goes along with
Okay. Now, you know, I guess I wanted to get in, you know, hearing more about the e-cigarettes and the vaping, and I'm not sure maybe you want to, who can touch upon that as far as people that would like to, as far as to work on quitting smoking or perhaps not smoking as far as the tobacco smoke. The e-cigarettes are obviously a different way to go. So tell us more about that, because I've certainly been hearing more, but I don't really know quite a bit about it.
Yeah, well, it's definitely gaining popularity amongst the community. I mean, new people coming in every day looking for vaporizers, e-cigs. We have disposable e-cigs. We have e-juice.
What does that mean?
The e-juice?
Yeah.
it's like a flavored juice. You can get nicotine in it.
Oh.
It's like different levels of nicotine.
You just flavors. Drink it?
No.
You put it in the vaporizer.
All right, I don't know. This is a new territory for me.
I know. We don't know. That's why they're here.
I go over this every day.
Okay,
so
good.
It's all right.
I'm talking to a professional.
Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's like orange juice, but it's different.
We do have orange flavor.
Oh, okay. You do. Okay.
But I'm not making a cocktail or any. This is like in the...
No. There are people that make them into essentially their own cocktail. They'll buy, say, like a Mountain Dew flavor or like something else. Like we have Fruity Pebbles. Like people mix them together.
Oh, and then it's part of this vaping thing?
Vaping, right.
Vaping. Okay. All right. Ooh, I'm learning something new every day. I don't... All right. So what are a lot of people... come to you. So you've been in Whitman a couple of years now. What is really popular in the store? Is it
a lot of people come in for vaping? Mainly vaping, and a lot of people come in for cigars.
Okay.
All right. Well, let's talk about some of the because I know there's people that really enjoy a good premium cigar.
Yeah.
I know some golfers do as well,
right.
And for different occasions, for a wedding
like
or
you're
perhaps
celebrating.
Or a celebration. Mm-hmm. So why don't you talk about those? Because I'm not really familiar with all the different brands, but give out some names and things that you guys sell and that people like to come in for.
Well, our top of the line cigars are Ashton, we have Cohiba, Macanudo, Romeo, Julieta, St. Louis Ray, Rocky Patel.
These are brands, right?
Right,
okay.
Exactly.
Got it.
And we also have other brands too, but those are probably our top selling brands.
Mm, okay.
All right, so would you guys be able to help me if I were looking for like a gift for someone? And I don't know a lot about cigars.
Yeah.
If I want to come in, can you guys help or people at the store answer questions for people like maybe myself that don't smoke cigars, but maybe I want to give it as a gift for someone, and I say I don't want to get him something that he doesn't like.
Right, yeah, well, if it's a gift, we usually go for a more mild cigar if you have no opinion, which is a lighter wrapper.
Okay.
Mm. And the darker the wrapper, the more harsh it's going to taste.
Oh, that's how you can tell.
Right, right.
Okay, interesting. Hmm. And then, accessories, because I know that's kind of part of the cigar smoking, right? You need to cut it and
things
like
that. We have cutters, humidors, all that.
Okay, got it. All right. Very informative. These are things I don't know.
Yeah, Lulu and Joe, and they're sponsoring our 9 o'clock hour. And again, it's Smoke and Ashes. So tell us again where the store is and what time you're open so people can come on over there.
Our store is on 410 Bedford Street, and it's open from 10 to 7 every day of the week.
All right, and you guys are going to be here for the 9 o'clock hour. I see the vehicle is parked out there right in front of the town hall on Route 27. So if anybody has any questions, they can come up and talk to you guys. You got a little table over there, right?
We do. We're giving out waters, magnets. What else are we giving out?
Pens. We have cutters, cigar cutters.
Oh, good. Ooh. Okay. All right. Well, you can come on over here and check that out. And Lulu Zhang and Joe Bellotta, thank you guys for sponsoring the 9 o'clock hour from Smoke and Ashes, smokeandashestobacco.com. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
It's what's new now. The South Shore's Morning News with Rob and Lisa on 95.9 WATD.
This is the South Shore Morning Tour.
And coming to you from beautiful Whitman today on our final stop of the South Shore Morning Tour 2015 edition. We visit a new town on the final Friday of every month to get out into the community to talk about this great place that we call the South Shore that we love to live in. We really do. And we're the South Shore's radio station. And we're going to be here till 10 o'clock today on the town green here in Whitman, right out in front of Town Hall. 9 o'clock hour of the tour is sponsored by Smoke and Ashes. If you like to enjoy a fine cigar during your time off, you can go to Smoke and Ashes. And the store manager from their Whitman store is on hand to talk about all their great imported and domestic cigars they carry at their store on Route 18 and 410 Bedford Street. You can check them out online. It's smokeandashestobacco.com. Well, don't forget, still coffee here from Honeydew Donuts, and the WATD prize wheel is available as well if you want to go up there and take a chance. Spin the wheel, and you could walk away a winner. We got some great prizes up there. And also, don't forget to put your name in the WATD, that pink can over there, for those King Richard Fair tickets, Lisa, that we're going to be drawing at 9:45.
That's absolutely right. You've still got time. We've got two pairs of tickets to King Richard's Fair. If you've never been, you have to check it out at least once. Costumes are not required, although encouraged, and it opens September 5th. Well, Speaking of smoke of a different kind, we have Fire Chief Tim Greno here with us this morning. Chief, thank you for joining us today.
Good morning, Lisa.
Yeah, great to have you here, Chief, and thanks for coming down here and being part of the tour. And we had a chance earlier to chat with the police chief, and we wanted to get kind of a sense as to what's going on in the community from the fire department's point of view. So tell us first a bit about yourself, Chief, and how long you've been in town and as Chief.
I'm a Whitman Townie, as the residents do refer to us as. I was born and raised in town. My family is from Whitman. My father actually spent 34 years as a firefighter in Whitman, and he retired as fire chief, and Chief Travis took over for him, and then I took over for Chief Travis. So I'm just about to start my 31st year.
Wow. And congratulations.
The last seven as chief. So.
Wow. Amazing. Well, we've been asking everybody, what makes Whitman so special?
It's a bedroom community. It's a close-knit, tight family community. A lot of the people who are born and raised here really don't venture far from Whitman. Mm. You know, I still see a majority of my classmates from the class of 87 on a regular basis, as does most of all of the high school classes. It's a nice, quiet bedroom community.
Chief Greno, one of the hot topics, unfortunately, these days is the opioid issue, and it has to be something that is top of your mind. What are you seeing, and how is the department reacting?
The opioid crisis in Whitman is definitely on the forefront of public safety. Mm. Myself and Chief Benton are actively working on the project with the epidemic with the school district and with our neighbors and residents. It's not a pretty picture in Whitman. Mm. Since January, there's been an average of 45 to 47 overdoses. Of those overdoses, we've administered Narcan 42 times. Wow. My paramedics have. And of those 42 times, I believe there's been 7 or 8 fatal deaths throughout the area.
What kind of strain does that put on? Because we've been talking about, you think about, the fire department and responding to, crashes or, house and building fires in different situations like that. How does this add to the strain in terms of having to be called out for these kinds of things?
That's one of the factors of working, of growing up and working and living in a small community. Mm. The majority of my personnel, and I believe a lot of the blue team, or our brothers and sisters of blue, live in Whitman. We know a lot of these victims or a lot of these patients that we're seeing. Mm. And for me to go to a house of a family that I grew up with to find their 17 or 18 or 50 year old resident who has overdosed and has either passed away or we brought them back with Narcan, it's very stressful. It's really starting to take a toll on our members and both the fire and police.
And that's a stress we don't always talk about. We talk about the financial stress, the fact that there are a lot of resources going to this, but this emotional stress we don't hit upon as much, and that's a good reminder that this really, it affects everyone in the community.
Right. Right, it really does. And, our call volume is up by about 200 runs. So my staff is a staff of 20 members. They do a phenomenal job day in and day out. And what we're seeing now is sicker patients, much sicker patients, much more serious incidents. The other night, they were confronted with a car crash with three critical patients with only four members.
Yeah. Mm.
So by adding the opiate issues with the hometown feel to it, it's
a lot.
It's very stressful for these guys.
It's a lot to deal with. Boy, anything that, as far as Chief, you'd like to see for the fire department or needs that you foresee in terms of the department needing any equipment or manpower or?
Anywhere that you go in the country and you ask a fire chief what they're looking for, the number one answer is going to be staffing.
Yeah.
And the town fathers and the finance committee and the residents are very gracious in Whitman. They treat us greatly, And, you know, staffing is expensive. Mm. And we'll find a way eventually.
Any other final messages for the residents?
Well, school is back in session, so I do ask everybody to please watch out for the school buses and the kids in the sidewalks. Mm-hmm. And fall is right around the corner, so I do ask everybody to change the batteries in their smoke and CO detectors.
Yeah, that's important to get out. Yeah, not only the smoke, you're right, but the CO detectors as well. That's something everybody's good to have.
And have a great, safe fall.
Thank you. And thank you so much, Chief, for joining us today.
That is, again, the fire chief, and Tim Greno is with us from Whitman.
And before you go, we just wanted to make sure that Richard Rosen said tomorrow is a special anniversary for you.
Special anniversary?
Oh, it is. It's my wedding anniversary. I'm glad he remembered.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, Fire Chief Tim Greno with us this morning. Thank you, Chief.
Thank you.
The South Shore's Morning News continues. We're the South Shore Morning Tour today on this final Friday in August. Good morning. I'm Rob Hakala, along with Lisa Azizian, coming to you from Route 27 in Whitman. We're highlighting the community of Whitman here on the front lawn of the beautiful landscape here around Whitman Town Hall. This is just gorgeous today. Lisa had a chance during the 9 o'clock news to kind of take a look more around the grounds. It's been so busy, but I wanted to kind of take it's just beautifully landscaped. It's really a nice, you know, historic building, and it's just great to see all the benches and people out here enjoying themselves and sitting on the front steps of Town Hall, just kind of relaxing and enjoying a Friday in August before the hustle and bustle of the fall.
I know, and for some of those folks, it's the hustle and bustle of getting back to school.
Uh-oh.
And by the way, school is in session today here in the town of Whitman, and we have grabbed a very busy woman from her routine to talk about that, and that happens to be the superintendent of schools, Dr. Ruth Whitner. Dr. Whitner, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me, Lisa. It's great to be here.
I know so how nice busy you are. It is. School was, first day was yesterday, right?
First day was yesterday. Teachers reported on Tuesday. Okay. They worked Tuesday and Wednesday. And yesterday we opened for the 2015-2016 school year.
Is there a collective sigh of relief when the first day comes? Because there's so much prep to get ready.
The collective sigh of relief came yesterday afternoon at 4:09 p.m. when our transportation coordinator, Diane Naughton, called me and told me that everyone was home safely.
Oh,
that is
good.
We want our children home safely all 180 days, but the first day, that really matters.
Mm. Yep. Tell us a little bit about the different schools and some of the different programs that might be new for this year.
Sure. Well, as you know, Whitman Hanson Regional School District is made up of 7 schools. In the town of Whitman, we have the Conley School, the Duval School, Whitman Middle School, and the Whitman Hanson Regional High School, which lies right on the town line between Whitman and Hanson. Many initiatives go on every year, and one of the things that I have said since I'm superintendent is every child, every day. And it's a focus that we keep because we don't want anyone to slip through the cracks. But this year I've expanded it to be every child, every day, with healthy minds and healthy bodies.
Mm. I like that. And what does that mean to you?
Well, I think it means that we feel that our today's children are under some stresses and influences that are quite different from when many of us grew up.
Yeah.
And I know you were talking to Chief Greno earlier about concerns about drug prevention and drug abuse. There are many influences, and we need to take focus on the fact that if our students are going to be career and college ready, they also need to be able to make very good decisions, be able to use social media intelligently and responsibly. All of those are things that weren't part of my education when I was in school, and we certainly need to focus on that. Academics are clearly important, but if students aren't available for learning, not much is going to happen.
Mm. Do you see social media as a positive influence or a negative influence, and how do you combat or deal with when it is seen in a negative light or used in a negative way?
I think it's like anything. It's like the internet, it's like the telephone. There are positives and negatives to everything. However, it is how you use it that matters. And I think for our students, one of the big concerns we have are things such as cyberbullying.
Mm-hmm.
Certainly when I was in school, if somebody gave you a hard time, you went home, you could forget about it. But the way it is today is students could be harassed 24/7, and we need to help them learn how to deal with it, how to put the phone away, to turn it off, and to know how to respond in a healthy manner. So it's certainly not good or bad. I don't know where I'd be without my smartphone. But it's also how I use it as well.
Yeah, that's a very good point.
Yeah. That's important, yeah, because you're right. I think it's important, Doctor, that we do kind of get that training because, you know, you're right. We can learn about, you know, science and math, but how do we deal by using those? So I guess if we're shown how to use them in a positive way in the school using computers, and I know teachers have different ways to get in touch with them online and get assignments and that kind of thing, that we can see that it's a positive, useful way to enhance learning.
Oh, it's absolutely a positive way in terms of just the information that's available to students and to all of us. When you have a question, you just can look it up on your phone, on your iPad. But you also need to know if your information is accurate, if it's well researched. So those are all challenges that we have.
But
clearly, every child, every day, healthy minds and healthy bodies.
Mm. What a great motto.
I like that. Yeah. What are some of the future things that you'd like to see as far as in the school system of Whitman? Anything that you'd like to see as far as some of your goals for the future?
Well, one of the things we're working on this year is we are always working to align our curriculum with standards. And that's been a challenge. It's something I worked on as administrator of curriculum, as assistant superintendent, and now again as superintendent. This year, for the first time ever, our curriculum coordinators in math, English language arts, science, and history are working kindergarten through grade 12 to ensure that we have longitudinal articulation from the time our students enter school until they graduate. And that's a new initiative for us. Those coordinators have often taught, been more based at the high school, and the challenge is to ensure that our students are academically competitive. It really requires we start at the very beginning.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
So that's a big initiative for us this year, and we're sort of starting slow, small steps to do this, but we're excited about it.
How about as far as feedback? Have we got parents and people in the community concerned about education? I imagine, you know, everyone's got an opinion or a thought. As far as, you know, parents and other folks, do you encourage communication?
We certainly do. There's been a lot of communication in regard to testing and the over-testing of students, Common Core, PARC, MCAS, all of those things, and we do want the questions to come to us. One of the big controversies last year was clearly about the PARC test, which is a national test. And our Board of Education will be voting, I believe, in November to determine whether that will be the Massachusetts statewide test or whether we're going to continue with MCAS. At this point, we don't know. So uncertainty is kind of hard for everyone, mm-hmm. and we're trying to steer the ship so people feel confident that they're doing the right thing in the classrooms.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Ruth Whitner has been with us this morning, Superintendent of Schools here in Whitman. We thank you so much for your time. We hope you have a great school year.
Well, thank you. It's been a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Whitner. I-44, the South Shore's Morning Tour continues. Coming to you from Whitman on Route 27 at Whitman Town Hall, I'm Rob Hakala along with Lisa Azizian. We're going to find out a bit more about the town of Whitman when it comes to its library system, right, Lisa?
Yes, absolutely. It seemed very fitting after talking with Dr. Whitner, the superintendent of schools, to also talk to Andrea Rounds, who is the director of the library here, the Whitman Public Library. Andrea, thanks for joining us today.
Oh, thank you so much for having me.
Well, Andrea, tell us a little bit about some of the programs at the library, you know, what ages they're geared for and things that you've got coming up this fall.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you so much for having me. I'm very happy to talk to you about all the programs we have going on at the library. We are just now finishing up our most successful ever summer reading program, where we had over 400 children participate. 400 children participated
this
summer.
That's good news.
Wow.
Not only is the library the place to come during the summer to make sure that you complete your summer reading homework, but time after time, studies have shown that children who don't read over the summer fall behind in school. And so...
Yeah.
What we do is we put on a fabulous program where we encourage children to continue reading over the summer and make progress towards their educational goals.
Mm-hmm.
So over 400 children visited the library and participated in programs 1,300 times this summer.
Wow.
Just in 10 weeks.
Oh, wow.
And so we had you know, the teen and tween finale last Friday, where children stayed at the library from 5 to 8 p.m., did capture the flag as a reward for their hard work over the summer. And those kids had a blast.
Capture the flag is fun.
Especially when you're doing it in the library.
Oh, wow.
I thought maybe she meant outside, in the driveway. No,
I didn't know that was allowed. I didn't, let alone encouraged. Okay. That sounds pretty fun.
The library is really a vibrant and lively place, and we really are encouraging people of all ages to come out and experience the joy that we have in providing materials for them.
Talk a little bit about the book club, the reading group.
Oh, we have several clubs that we sponsor at the library, and one of them is Mary's Book Club that meets on the third Friday of the month. That book club has been meeting for over 10 years, and they are currently discussing Rebecca. So if you want more information, you can always call the library and sign up for that program. I think there's some limited spots available. And then on the second Thursday of the month, or the second Friday, excuse me, we'll be going over to the Council on Aging. And actually, one of our longtime library employees, Barbara, is going to be having a book buzz with the seniors.
A
so
book buzz.
Make sure that you're down there at the Council on Aging and welcome Barbara. She's just a wealth of knowledge, and I know people really enjoy speaking to her.
I like
then
that.
Then we also have a mystery book club, and we'll be starting back up our Literary Lions book club in November.
She can't give us too many details because it's a mystery, so I can't say too much. Andrea, how long have you been doing this, and why did you decide to get involved in this kind of career?
I've been involved in libraries for 13 years, and I think one of my favorite memories as a child is going down to the library, getting my first library card, and then being able to have the freedom to choose what I wanted to read.
Mm.
So my mother's an educator as well, and she really instilled in me the passion for learning, and this is something that I just, it was a natural fit in my life.
Aww. That is so fun, and I know your son, baby Evan, has just arrived. I see him over in the distance there, and I imagine Aww. That'll be one of the fun things that you get to share with your son when he starts to read, is going to the library and getting to pick
out
books.
I was selfishly going to ask Andrea what the hot 19-month-old book are right now.
Absolutely. Come on down and check out some Mo Willems. We have some great books. And in fact, if you want to bring your son to Wiggle Worms, we have a great program for the youngest babies on Monday mornings, starting back up in September.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be having some story times. We always sing songs, crafts, and read books to engage of all ages, but we start them at birth.
So down. And I can find the schedule on your website?
Yes, you can. We have whitmanpubliclibrary.org. We have an event keeper, which has a calendar of events, and we're very happy to talk to you about or share our information about upcoming programs there.
Okay.
It's been
We're big fans of the Belly Button book by Sandra Boynton. So
wonderful.
Yeah,
yes,
it's
you gotta
a good
find
one.
That belly button.
Yeah, the beep boo, absolutely.
What? Where am I?
I'll show you the book someday.
I don't know about the beepo.
Yeah, that's okay. What the hippos call their belly buttons.
All right. Well, Andrea, it has been so fun to talk about someone that is very passionate about what they do. And thank you for sharing. I know, by the way, our own Dave Skill wanted to say hello. I know he worked with you for the Love Your Library program, some of the feature series that he worked on. So he heard we were going to be having you on the program. So Dave Skill says hello. And if you're ever looking for us to come by, I'd be happy to read anything.
That's fun.
I'm always welcome. I'm very excited to read Mike Mulligan and the Steam Shovel. It's one of my favorites. So I know you might be sick of it, but I'm not. I'm going to read Mike Mulligan and the Steam Shovel to all the kids. It's one of my favorite books.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thank you. We've been chatting this morning with Andrea Rounds, Library Director, WhitmanPublicLibrary.org. That's where you can get all the details of these great book clubs and the schedule for all the fun activities for kids of all ages. Thanks,
Thank you, Andrea. All right, we're going to wrap things up in just a moment. Reminder, this back-to-school season, remember to drive safe and be mindful of children walking to and from school. We talked about that importance with school going back in session. This reminder from JK Contracting, family-owned and operated with over 40 years of experience in the construction industry. They specialize in all phases of general contracting, renovations, and remodeling. Call today, 781-331-0640, 781-331-0640, or visit them online, jkcontractingllc.net. That's JK Contracting, wishing the kids a safe return back to school. All right, time to get ready to wrap things up from Whitman. I want to say it was certainly a very fun time out on the South Shore Morning Tour, Lisa. And we want to thank our premier sponsor, East Coast Press. Thank you so much for making the prize wheel and the WATD Frisbees and, hey, this tent and the banner and everything else. We just look plain awful without East Coast Press. Thank you. Honeydew Donuts. Thank you,
Kara
Bowen. They're a locally owned business. Kara Bowen there, the Bowen family. Mm-hmm. They started Honeydew Donuts and they still run it. So thank them for providing the coffee and those delicious the cinnamon sticks, which were so popular, they ran out. I hope to have you back for 2016, Kara.
Yeah,
thank you so much.
Thank you to the crew in Abington for helping out and the crew in Rockland, the Rockland store also. Thank you.
Thanks to Dave Friedman and Instabrite. Instabrite, they can clean your house, instabrite.com. McLaughlin Chevrolet in Whitman, thank them so much. They're a great local business. And smokeandashestobacco.com. I want to thank our on-site engineer, Larry Nelson, and engineering assistant, Ryan Stanton, who also the prize wheel director there. Sandy Rollick and Jackie and Joyce and Nancy Sheehan from our sales department, and thank you. Also, Kevin Tachi. We want to thank again the folks at Whitman and Hanson Community Access, Channel 12. Thank you, Kevin, for simulcasting this. Our social media director, Mariel Reed. Morning Tour assistant, Jonathan Papalardo. Dave Skill, WATD anchor, back at the newsroom at our news center in Marshfield. And running the board back at Master Control, he does it all, David Wolfson. Well, along with Lisa Azizian, I'm Rob Hakala. Thank you, Whitman.
Thank you, Whitman.
And it's been a lot of fun. This is our final stop of the 2015 South Shore Morning Tour. We'll see you on the road next summer. Thanks, guys.